Welcome back to Stephanie Reacts to the Bureau of Magical Things. This is season 1, episode 12, aisle 13. This could be an aisle on a plane, aisle in a shopping store, or aisle in the library, the bookshop kind of thing, where the stairs keep moving. Or ladders, I think it's ladders, isn't it? Aye, ladders. The ladder keeps moving and things. But last week, Peter found it too much. He did far too much, we shouldn't have knew. And Roxy fell in love with him. Fell in love with Peter. She didn't wipe his memory or anything. So, yikes. We're going to see maybe Peter at the bookshop more often, without the Professor Remdale's there, just him and Roxy maybe, spending some time together. I don't know. Something will have to happen, either Peter backs out from it, like pretends he doesn't know anything at all, or he's going to get his mind wiped by the investigation team. Magic Bureau, the BMI I think it's called, or BMI, oh wait, BIM, or whatever it is. So Peter has the idea, one of the two, back off, or, yeah, so let's jump into this, starting now.
River City High.
Kim, I bet he's an elf.
Peter.
I'm just asking.
You've been asking all day, and I'm telling you, magical people don't go to human schools.
You do.
I go to both.
You're lucky. Has Roxy mentioned me?
Peter, forget Roxy. Forget everything you saw. Don't talk about it to anyone, ever. Okay?
All right.
Promise?
No, yes, I promise.
See you later.
Off to your other school?
Peter.
Sorry.
Do we have cameras ready or something? We've got Peter in the school. Or maybe a book we've got Peter in. That's what he was.
Hey, Manny, what's up? You know what we haven't done in ages? A sleepover. I guess.
My dad's away for the weekend and Mum's at some conference thing, so I was thinking maybe tomorrow night. How about it? It'll be fun.
Sure. Why not?
What was that?
Farrah, are you okay?
Yeah. Fine.
Oh, something happened there.
See you then.
I was about to take away my chief fuel and something happened there.
The library and books were flying off the shelves. They were stacking up just like this.
You did magic without being here.
Like when you sent the message when you and Dara were trapped on the beach.
What's going on, Professor?
Hard to say. I've never seen anything like this.
I thought you knew everything.
I have been known to give that impression, but in this case, I'm flummoxed.
I know this book. It's the one I was touching when I got zapped by Lily and Imogen.
Clara, you're right.
I'm fine.
What did she do?
Whoa, what was that?
Oh,
Clara?
That's our teacher. Hey, I'm at yours. Where are you? You weren't supposed to come over till 5.
Mum dropped me off early. When will you be here?
I'm just finishing some stuff I had to do.
Oh, it's no problem. Your dad's here. He let me in.
I've made myself at home.
Great. See you soon.
You can't be with Matilda. What if you turn her into a guinea pig?
She's at my house. I have to go.
Immo and Lily.
Oh, pretty. Thanks.
Where's your stuff? It was a last-minute thing. Where do you live?
Close.
So why don't you go home and get something?
Not that close.
What school do you guys go to?
You wouldn't know it. It's kind of small.
Boutique.
Okay.
Sorry to interrupt. Kara, can we have a word before I go?
What do your parents do?
Mum's a vet. And Dad's a policeman.
What does he work with Kyra's dad?
I wouldn't know. And Imogen's dad is a...
farmer.
He... sells basketballs.
And your mother?
She cuts
toenails.
She works in a salon and cuts hair and toenails.
That's
Let's see where Kyra's got to.
You should have asked me first, Kyra. I don't know these girls.
I'm sorry, Dad. It was all a bit of a rush.
Well, do their parents even know they're here? I should call them.
They're working. Probably not a good idea to disturb them.
Yeah, but I...
Dad!
Knock, knock! Imogen, what if I'd been Matilda? Little circles round and round. Little circles up and down. Do you want me to show you how to brush yours too?
I'll pass, thanks.
Aww.
Are you two finished?
Not your girlfriend.
I don't know how much longer we can keep this up. Especially when a certain person is so careless.
That's how I always brush my teeth. Do you think Darren and Roxy found a way to turn Maxwell back?
If they had, they'd be here.
I can't get rid of them.
When they're on their fear, you think they're fiery. You can help them with the ears themselves.
This is totally out of control.
What do we do?
Shut you in a cupboard. You're a menace. What was that?
What's what?
There's something in your... They're both visible. So you better tell me the professor's not a guinea pig anymore.
I wish we could, but... as you can see.
You lost him?
He was here a moment ago.
Well, find him. Professor!
Professor!
Professor! Professor!
Are you glued to that dresser?
No, I just like it here.
Kara, what is your problem?
Problem?
You've been acting strange all night. Although not as strange as your kooky friends. Look, I was really hoping that we could talk
about... Did you find Lily?
Lily wasn't at the library. The poor little guinea pig seems to have disappeared.
Yeah, well, if she's feeling sick, she's probably gone home.
You were right.
So, I guess it's bedtime.
I should put these in the wash.
You're doing your washing now.
Yeah, you're a bit pungy. Oh, wouldn't want the smell to keep you awake. Imogen, why don't you keep Matilda company? Thanks,
Ewan. Oh, no, the girl stands in here. She's got no sun's up.
Isn't this a great sleepover?
No.
Maxwell.
Professor Maxwell.
Professor. Professor, don't move.
Professor.
I take the book after that start. Probably all the powers come from all the books in my brain.
Standing there.
Are you okay? I think so. I'm sorry I turned you into a guinea pig, Professor. I didn't mean to, it just happened.
That would explain my craving for carrots.
What did you do to turn him back?
I don't know. All she did was touch the Conjuring book.
Aye.
I know things have been...
Shield! Yay, I'm in a 40. But now we have to work out what happened to the book.
When I was looking at that book, I saw a glowing sphere.
The orb.
Any idea what that means?
The mind does play tricks. It was likely the product of the stress that you were under, all the random magic going on.
No.
I guess. But why a glowing ball?
Why did you turn me into a guinea pig?
Thank you, the beach, Tyra. You're in the boat.
Any other random events since yesterday?
No, whatever it was seems to have settled down. But I still can't help thinking it's somehow connected to that book.
Of course I'll look into it. But I'm certain that the book has absolutely nothing to do with it.
Okay, Professor. You're the expert.
But just to be on the safe side, we think we should skip class for a few days until I've had time to look into this properly.
If you think I should.
Oh, no.
Ladder?
Take this to the restricted section. Keep it safe. No one is to touch it. Understood?
One. That was aisle 13. I think the camera's a wee bit wonky. 1 minute. There we go. I think that's a bit better. But anyway, I can say that was aisle 13. Near the end yet. When Kyra seen that orb. I know. That's the orb from the beach kind of thing, right? But tell me this. When she controlled the library from the beach, was it from aisle 13, though? Where she controlled Lada? Because I think maybe Lada was in aisle 13. Oh, pardon me. And because she was controlling the library, she had to go through the different bookcases and stuff. Maybe aisle 13 was infected with it. Or maybe the person who owned that beach, that magical beach, you know, owned that orb thing, hidden the orb inside that book. That's why Professor Maxwell put it to a restricted area. But, oh, Kyra. Kyra's power's grown, it is. That was grown because of that book, but it's still grown. As Roxanne says, transformation spells is upper class kind of thing, like senior class. Because they're junior, they've not been taught that yet. And Callie just touched the book, but touched the book, then touched Maxwell, and he turned into a guinea pig. She did the same to the wheelbarrow, to the vegetables, make it moving. Then she touched by mistake. Lily turned her into, Lily is a fairy, but she turned her tiny as a fairy. Then she tried to get Imogen out of the way, and she hurt Imogen, and Imogen's pointy ears showed. So, Kyra's powers are out of whack in this episode. I'm glad Peter wasn't in it. Well, he was in it at the start just, and Kyra told him to keep his nose out of stuff. But I'm glad that he wasn't in most of this, like, near the end of it and all that, in the middle. Because he'd get in the way, he would, with all the magic stuff, all the hiccups. And Maddie, she nearly caught them also, with the magic. Because they're getting Kyra in it, getting careless with their powers. Especially Imogen, when she was brushing her teeth. Maddie nearly walked in on her. Because that's when Lily saw her. Grab the toothbrush fast, then this is how we brush our teeth. That was good, it was. And I thought it was funny, it's when Imogen and Lily were doing with the fruits, making them dance and talking, kind of thing, like the twins. I was like, that was funny. But, get to the serious part now. Maddie, her parents are getting a divorce. That is good and it's no bad. At least a parent is still alive, not one of them died or anything. So that means she can visit her dad and her mum. Depends what house she goes to live in, or depends what house she's forced to live in. Because if she's forced to live with her dad, she can go visit her mother. But if she's forced to live with her mother, she can go visit her dad kind of thing. So yeah, that's a plus, but it's a downfall to having your family broke up. But when Kyra and I wanted to put Madison in sleep together, she's been to her sleep so we can look for the professor and stuff because he ran away. Lily wanted to put a spell on her to put her to sleep. But glad she never. I'm glad she was there for her too. Did you listen to my conversation? No. She did. But she couldn't help it because she was tiny. She just done, I seen you were sad. So, that was good, yeah, it was. Everybody needs a friend like Lily. Maybe a crazy friend like Imogen. So, I'm glad the four of them, well, Lily and Imogen became pals with Madison. And I hope they have more night things. I forget what it's called. Sleepovers. That's a sleepovers. Hope we have more sleepovers. So it would be fun to see the four of them again, like having interaction with each other. But they might have to try to hide the magic a few times. They might have to hide it. And that would be weird for them. I just saw some moves there in the hall. I have myself. It's alright. But doors there, hall doors there. I'm looking, I thought I saw like something move. But anyway, the next episode's called Forces of Attraction. Maybe Peter and Roxy? Because last episode Peter kept asking there. And Roxy asked for me, Roxy spoke about me or anything. And Kyra's done, just shut up and go away kind of thing. Or it could be Kyra, the force to the attraction of the books. Like she was in this one, my dream. Or we saw Roxy when Maxwell was putting the book away in the secret area, anything, restricted area. Roxy was listening. So that could be the force of attraction, like, was in the restricted area? Or, why did they put this book here? Is this book dangerous? She might be like attracted to go and sit, look at it and stuff. So that could be a good thing or could be a bad thing if it is Roxy gone searching. It was good that they kept Kyra's name away from the DMI. That was T. And it kind of turned them back after touching that wee orb that she saw. It was a book she touched, but she saw an orb. So that's what it confirmed to me. Oh, sorry. That's what this G Fuel should have kept me awake. It's caffeine. But anyway, I'm a wee bit tired, but I don't know how. I've been busy all weekend. So that has confirmed for me. That orb belongs to that beach, or the boats where it's in the beach. That beach is just a secret land that's been created. So yeah. So everyone, don't forget to hit a like button, subscribe, comment down below, and have a good day, good night, good week, good weekend. Stay safe out there, everyone. And I'll see you then. The next one. Bye, everyone.